So this next pimping question, also related to fevers, is what do you do with subjective fevers? I write this on my charts all the time. What does subjective fever mean, first of all? Subjective means that it wasn't quantified, they didn't check a temperature, but they felt the patient and they felt warm. What do you do with that? Do you treat it as a fever? Do you say, well, it probably wasn't a fever? Oh, you probably bundled the baby too much and that's why they're warm. What do you think about that? Well, if you've been listening to my series, you know that you should trust the patient. And if they told you they felt warm, they're probably right. But what is the data? What is the evidence-based medicine behind it? Simple enough. If they say they felt a fever on the kid, studies have shown that 80% of the time, they are correct. So if this is a two-month-old and they told me they felt warm, I take that as a temperature and I do a septic workup even if they don't have fever in the ER. Now, I might do a limited septic workup, but I do. If they're more than 3 months old and they look great, then I treat it like a kid with a fever that looks good. I check for the common sources, ear, throat, urines, chest x-ray, if they're coughing and things like that, look for rashes and things like that. But I do take it as a fever. They think they had a fever, they had a fever. And I mentioned something about, oh, they bundled them too much, so they heated up. Well, there's plenty of literature showing that bundling a kid does not cause fever. All right, that's it for this one. On the next one, we're going to talk about, my kid has a fever, he's teething. What is that all about? Actually, let's not do another video. Let's do it right now. So, if the mother tells you, my kid had a fever, I think they're teething. Is that true? Is that wives' tales? Is that something like that? What do you think? What do you think? Well, here's the answer. Teething by itself does not cause a fever. So if they had a fever, it's something else. Now, it might not be something bad, but it's not just because the teeth is erupting. Here's a more challenging question. Blaming fever on an ear infection. Also wrong. Now, I see doctors doing this all the time, and honestly, I do it all the time. Oh, your kid has a fever, I see it. Oh, they got an ear infection. Here's the deal. An ear infection is a localized infection. It shouldn't reset the hypothalamic set point for fever. So they have a fever because they have a bacterial infection. They have a fever because they have a virus that's going on that is also causing a red ear with an infusion. That itself is not causing a fever. Essentially, some pediatrics experts compare that to saying that you have a fever because you have a paronychia. Paronychia is a little infection on the side of your nail. Or you have a little pimple and you have a fever. It's just wrong. The body does not reset the hypothalamic set point just because you have a pimple. So the same thing is with an ear, same thing is with teething. However, in clinical practice, we a lot of times blame fever on ear infections. Because they have an ear infection, whatever is causing a strep, pneumonia, Moraxella catarrhalis, whatever virus is causing the infection is also causing the fever. So we just say they have a fever and they have an ear infection. So it's not that it's wrong, but it's a misnomer. We're just calling it something that it's really not. All right, I'm done with this video. We'll see you in the next one.